Scott Church here, Category1Games.com. Today we're going to take a special look at the complete guide to Star Wars collectibles. Now the reason I'm doing this is I want to see what they have to say about the Star Wars CCG. Having been the largest seller of the game in the world for many years, you would think they'd come talk to me about pricing. Mainly because I know the pricing on the game. And you would think they'd come to an authority on it, but I was never contacted for this. So I want to show you the prices that they show and talk about it. First off, this is made by Beckett Entertainment. Now, when you think of sports card pricing, you think of Beckett, generally the most well-respected authority on that out there. Now, it has toy lines, and it gives information about those toy lines. It has vehicles and play sets, Funko. And I mean, this magazine's really cool. It's fun to take a look at and just see, the information in it, old pictures of cool toys. And just being a general Star Wars fan, it's kind of a cool magazine to look at. Now, this came out before The Force Awakens hit, or just around the same time. And so, those figures were starting to take off in popularity. And with that came new popularity for older Star Wars items because it's drawing fans back into it, just like it did for the Star Wars CCG. Now, they put the gaming in the back behind the trading cards. So here's the gaming page start. Now, I don't know where they got these prices from, and I'm pretty curious to see who they or where they picked it from. If it was just like an old Scry, they picked it up and said, yep, that's it. So let's take a look at, like right here, we've got Dark Jedi Presence, $4 to $10. I believe when I had this on my site, Star Wars CCG on my site, that card was nowhere near $10. Darth Vader, 10 to 25. I mean, that's a big range. Some of these cards are spot on. Others are just so far off. Like DS613 is $8 on a high, and Dutch is $8 on a high and low of $2.50. I believe Dutch was like a 25-cent card, if I'm not mistaken. The pricing in here is just really bad. So it goes from Premier, and then they go to Hoth next, which is really interesting. Because it's like, why did they jump all the way to Hoth? Let's look at like General Veers, right? $3 to $8. That's usually a higher price card. I'm just looking for anything that seems a little too off. Like a Stalker up to $10. Stalker was never $10. Same with Tyrant, $8. I mean, these cards are not that high. Jedi packs, who's paying 40 cents to a dollar for some of these? It's just really interesting. So then it goes, there's a New Hope, and it comes back to New Hope. Like, here's $10 for a Conquest Chewbacca, 15, low of 6. I mean, their pricing is just out there. Here's Cloud City. Fett is $20. When was the last time Fett was $20? I mean, it's pretty ridiculous. Dagobah has Avenger up to $10, low of 4. I mean, some of the pricing on this, like, let's look at Jabba's Palace, right? So Jabba's Palace, Jabba the Hutt, here we go, up to $10, Jaquil, $3, any of these that are a dollar in here are even overpriced. It's just ridiculous looking at some of this pricing. And I wonder who they got this information from, because quite frankly, they never contacted me, and I've talked to other sellers of the game, and they didn't talk to them. So who priced this? Where did they get this from? And that's what's frustrating, is if you're going to make a magazine talking about a game, you might as well talk to the people that actually sell it and get correct pricing. So, like, here's Death Star 2. I mean, some of this pricing is off, just really low. Like, here's Emperor Palpatine, $60 on the high, right? Home One, $10 on the high. Luke Skywalker, Jedi Knight, $60. And they didn't even do Reflections pricing. They did like Reflections 2 and 3 premium, but they didn't do Reflections foil cards, which is really disappointing. Same with Endor. They didn't do the foil cards from it. And it's like, if you're going to do a magazine about pricing, why aren't you including all the information or talking to someone that can help you figure that out, right? It's just really fascinating what they were pulling this information from. So like Reflections 3, I mean, some of this, just the pricing is all over the place. Like, putting every card for Reflections 3 at the lowest at $2.50. There's a lot of cards that aren't worth anything in Reflections 3. No one's You know, no one's paying $250 for, I don't know, your ship, right? They say $3 is a high, $125 is a low. The card never sold, right? Okay, so here's the end of Star Wars CCG. Again, no reflections won, no AIs for any of Theed, Coruscant, or Tatooine. Really interesting. You know, they put them out of order of their when they were released. Here's the next one. They went into Star Wars by Wizards of the Coast. And then they went into Young Jedi. And it's really interesting, like Young Jedi, you know, they didn't, I don't know where they got their pricing on this either. You know, and the other thing too is they didn't include, there's no beta set for Menace of Darth Maul, which I bet they didn't even know there was a beta set. You know, let's see, do they have foils for it at least? Do they have the whole thing? Jedi Reflections. They don't have any of the foil or any of the reprinted foils from it. They just have the combined cards, which is kind of an interesting choice. And I was going to say, did they did get all the sets for Young Jedi. But look at this. This is Star Wars miniatures, right? Star Wars gaming cards price guide. And then they go into Rebel Store miniatures, Clone Strike. And then they end with Alliance and Empire miniatures. You know, it doesn't make sense to me. There's another, you know, few sets after this, like six more sets. Why did they end it right here? It's like they had a page count. They had to get to that count, and then they just stopped. And, like, they could have just included one more page and included front, back, and gotten the rest of all of the Star Wars miniatures figures. You know, and the pricing on this, I don't know where they got their pricing. Their pricing is off. It's not realistic. It's not what the going market is, which makes me wonder if the rest of the pricing for figures and these other sets are totally off too, because they didn't get it right for the card game. They didn't get it right for the miniature game. So are any of the pricing in here correct? And if they're not, why did they even put this out? I mean, this was a magazine that wasn't cheap. It was $10, $9.99 here in the US. So it's not like this magazine was just like a $2 or $3 thing. This was $10 for incorrect information. You know, it's really disappointing when you pick up something from Beckett, who's known as the experts, to find pricing like that. And for them to do pricing, I wonder where they got their pricing from. As I've said, did they just go to eBay and look at completed listings or finished listings? Or, you know, I don't know what they did, but it's severely disappointing. If you want to find correct pricing for the different card games that are out there, you can visit our site, category1games.com, where you can find a lot of great collectible card games.